Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by RoboJax. In this lecture, we are going to see how we can use this MCP9808 temperature sensor to display the temperature on this 7-segment display based on TM1637. In a separate lecture, we have through all the specification, code, and explanation of this. And also with another lecture, we have gone through this TM1637, smaller and larger version. The value beyond the decimal point will be discarded, and we are going to round it. In this video, we are going directly to combine both of these to display the temperature. As you are aware that this does not have the decimal point. And here is the wiring diagram of MCP9808 temperature sensor with this 4-digit TM1637 display. We have from the top of this one, we have the clock have been connected to pin 5. Digital data in out, DIO, have been connected with a pink to pin 6. Blue is ground, have been connected to the ground. And 5 volts is green, have been connected to 5 volts here. From here, VCC have been connected to 3.3 volts. Ground have been connected using an orange wire to the ground. SCL is connected to a 5, and SDA have been connected using a red wire to a 4. This is the wiring for MCP9808. The left wire have been connected to 3.3 volts instead of 5 volts in the previous lecture. The ground have been connected using orange to the ground, and this pin SCL have been connected using red wire to A5. SDA have been connected using this brown to A4. And here is for the LED display TM1637. The top one is the clock. Using brown wire have been connected to 5. The purple wire is the digital in-out, have been connected to pin 6. Blue is ground, have been connected to ground of Arduino in here, and green is 5 volts, which have been connected to 5 volts here in Arduino. Let me now explain the code for the MT1637 with the MCP9808. We have included the math. This is a library that is needed to round because the LED display does not display the decimal point, so we want to use round, and for round we need to include math. This is needed. Wire is part of IDE. These two are part of IDE. This is, however, you have to include it, and I have provided you the link in the tutorial. Follow the instruction. This is exactly the same. From here, we have the start, and this is the end of TM1637. This is exactly as before. This is part of the library Arduino. This is, you need to download this TM1637 zip file library. Define the pin 5 for the clock and pin 6 for the digital in out. And then we use from this class, we create an instance, we call it display, and we pass these two, clock and digital and out, as I've explained it before. This is just creating a blank for 4 digits. We put 0x0. This 0 means 0 of hexadecimal value. For 4 digits, we create 0 and we call it blank, so we can use it. This is the serial monitor setup, and we're using display.setBrightness 0x0f, we set the display brightness to maximum. And here, this was as explained in the actual module, it just sends this error in case if there is an issue with it. inside the loop. This was exactly as before I've explained it. And here we use display.segment, set segment blank. This blank is an array above which with the zero values to it clear the screen because the display will continuously read. And then this is the method or function that I've explained that gets the Celsius value, which is below. And then before that, we use round. Round can be used this way. We put open close parenthesis and you put your value and it will round it for you. And we are getting the Celsius and we are rounding it and then using the display show number decimal to display it on the screen. And then we wait 3 seconds. This time we use Fahrenheit with F. Then we wait a second and the code repeats, continuously displaying Celsius and Fahrenheit. I've also enabled and kept the serial monitor in case if you want to play with it. Otherwise, you can delete this. This was how to use this TM1637 display with MCP9808 temperature sensor. Thank you for watching. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from RoboJax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.